Let's talk about integration by parts, but I'm not going to talk about please let your students use the DM method because we did that already last year. In this video, I would like to talk about why I don't use the LIATE method. What's the LIATE method? Let me just give you guys an example first. Suppose we have to integrate x squared times ln x. And yes, this right here needs integration by parts, but the hard part is, how do we know which part to choose to be differentiated and the other part to be integrated? Well, that's what this right here comes in. So the idea is that you are going to go in this order. If you see log functions in your integral, you'll choose this to be differentiated. Next is the inverse functions such as inverse tangent, inverse cosine, etc. And then next is algebraic such as x to some power. And then next is sine cosine for the trig functions. And lastly, we have the exponential functions, of course, e to the x and things like that. And as we can see, we see log right away. So we'll choose that to be differentiated. So let's go ahead and put down a d and an I, plus minus to get ready. We will choose that. And you know, thanks to that, it's pretty easy. And of course, we do x squared to be integrated. Go ahead, do that. Go ahead and do this. It seems pretty nice. And let's just finish this and we will talk. So we get 1 third x to the third power times ln x. And then we are going to multiply by these two things together and put that inside of an integral and subtract that. Here we have 1 over x times 1 over 3. And then we have the x to the third power. And let's put down the x. Cancel this out. And this right here becomes a 2, right? And of course, to integrate this, we just add 1 to the power, which is 3, divided by the new power, so we have 1 over 3. So all in all, this right here is just 1 over 3 x to the third power ln x minus 1 third times 1 third, so 1 over 9, and then x to the third power. Done. So this right here is very nice. And I can also give you guys another example. So if you are looking at the integral of x times sine x instead, well, we don't have the log anymore. We have trig function, but you see it's down here. So that means we should actually choose x to the first power because it's above the trig functions. So we'll choose the x to be differentiated. So let's just go ahead and put that down, put down the x right here and put down the sine x right here. Okay, x is algebraic, x to some power, and trig is down below, so do this. And of course, you all know the integration by parts with the DM method, the DI setup. Do it once, and then do it right here. But we can get to zero, so let's do another row. Alternate the sign, right? Plus, minus, and also that. Okay, do this again, we get zero. Do this, we get negative sine x. Ladies and gentlemen, this times this is the answer, right? So we get negative x cosine x, and then plus sine x. Done deal, so put on the plus c right here. Again, everybody happy. So it seems like this right here is actually a very good tip for us to remember and help us with integration by parts. But I will have to say I agree. This right here helps about like 80% of the time. I would say the majority of the the classic calculus 2 typical homework questions, yes, this right here would definitely be helpful. But if you are trying to do some like a hard to questions, then that not really. If you haven't learned all the integration techniques, then you should check out sponsor today, Brilliant. We are currently looking at the integral calculus course. Here, they cover all the integration techniques that you have to know, such as integration by parts and different kinds of substitutions. Taking a course from Brilliant is really fun because they will keep you engaged by storytelling and cool animations. Over the past year, they have built a whole new platform for their courses that takes interactivity to the next level. You will see hands-on activities while you go through their courses, and especially they have over 60 interactive courses in math and science, and they range from beginner level to advanced level. So you will be able to find courses that you like and you can start learning something new. And I have a special link for you guys, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen. If you use the link, you will have a 20% off discount. So go ahead and check them out, and I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video. Number 3, let's look at the integral of secant to the third power x. We actually have to use integration by parts. First off, we are going to break this apart into secant to the first power times secant to the second power. So let's see how it looks like. So let me put this down right here first, and then secant to the second power, next like that. Now, we do have two parts. And by the way, do not replace this with a tangent squared plus one. It's not going to help. We have to use integration by parts, right? But anyway, we have secant to the first, and then the other part is secant to the second. They are both trig functions. Which part should we choose to be differentiated, right? So this is one of the things that, Yeah. But anyway, here is the deal. I really like to tell my students that when you do the integration by part with the DS setup like here, always pick the part to be integrated first, because it's always harder to integrate something, right? Well, maybe that's not true. I actually just remembered it's not true, but yeah, anyway, it's usually harder to integrate something rather than differentiate. So just ask yourself, can we integrate secant x? Yes, but it's easy. No. Can we integrate secant squared x? Yes, it's easy. Yes. So we will be integrating secant squared x, and let's just differentiate secant x. It works. So integrating this, we get tangent x, and differentiating that, we get secant x, another tangent x. Ladies and gentlemen, this times this is the first part of the answer, and we get secant x times tangent x. That's how we squeeze out the first part of the answer for this integral. Next, we multiply these two things together and then put that inside of an integral. It's a minus integral, and we have secant and tangent to the second power. And this is the time that we will be using the identity, and tangent squared x is the same as secant squared x minus 1. So if you look at this carefully, I'm going to actually write this down again, because you will see this is actually a repeating case. So we are looking at the integral of secant to the third power x dx, that's equal to that secant x tangent x. This right here is inside of the integral, but we will have to distribute the secant into here, so we get minus integral of secant to the third power x, and then dx that, and we will also have to distribute this to that, and negative negative, so it becomes the positive here, integral, and then we just have secant x dx. Now you see, this, we can just move that to the other side, and we'll end up with 2 integral of secant to the third power x dx. And you see this right here is just secant x times tangent x, and this is over there already, and this right here, it's a standard result, and we just know that that's going to be ln absolute value of secant x plus tangent x. If you really want to put secant x right here, yes, you can integrate that just by putting down a standard result. But once you multiply the second row, the two things from the second row, yeah, no, that's why, right? Always think about what to choose to be integrated first. But anyway, we are not done yet, because we don't want this 2 right here. So divide every body by 2. Therefore, the integral of secant to the third power x dx is equal to 1 half secant x tangent x plus 1 half ln absolute value of secant x plus tangent x. And then, of course, plus c. We are done. Okay, this is number 4. Let's take a look at the integral of ln x over 1 plus ln x, and then square dx. Trust me, we do integration by parts with this one. All right, so let's go ahead and put down a d and also the I, plus or minus, and thanks to this, okay, we see ln x, which is the natural log function, and likewise, we also have the natural log on the bottom. So it seems like we should just put the whole thing down to be differentiated. Ln x over 1 plus ln x and square, because both of them have the log, right? Wow. Do you really want to differentiate this? It's doable, but do we really have to? Is life that hard? You guys can let me know. We really just have to think about which part we should choose to be integrated first, and we have to do it carefully. Shall we just put down lnx right here to be integrated? No, because we have to do integration by parts for that, right, technically. So does that mean we should just put down the rest? And this is on the bottom, so let me write down 1 over 1 plus lnx and then square. Can we integrate this? No. But what if we try to do use up, let u equal the inside? Well, the derivative of the inside is 1 over x. Unfortunately, there's no x. But now, just think about it. Wouldn't it be nice if we happen to have an x right here? Yes, it would be so nice, because then we can just proceed by u sub let u equal 1 plus lnx, and du is just equal to 1 over x dx, and you see this integral becomes the integral, and then we have 1 over u square, and this right here, and the dx, imagine that, is just going to be the du. And this right here is just going to give us, you know, negative 1 over u to the first power, right, after you integrate that. So this right here now is doable, but we didn't have the x in the beginning. Don't worry, let's just go ahead and do the following. If you don't have it, multiply by that, and don't forget to do the same thing on the top. So now, if we actually just do that, you see, we have the bottom portion right here. That part is to be integrated. So what does that mean? That means we should just take the top part to be differentiated. So let's go ahead and do that. Here we have the x times lnx. Yes, very nice. Check this out. When we integrate this guy, it's just negative 1 over u, and u is that. So we end up with negative 1 over 1 plus lnx. And when we differentiate this guy, we use the product rule. So we do x times the derivative of the second plus the second function times the derivative of the first, which is just 1. Just like that, right? And now, let's construct our answer like the good old way, right? So we do this times this. That will give us the first part of the answer. So we have negative, and we have x lnx over that on the bottom. And we are going to be multiplying these two things together. But check this out. Negative times negative is positive. I know. But let me just say that. Plus the integral. Check this out. What's this? This is just 1, and then plus lnx. Here we have 1 plus lnx. When you multiply this, they cancel each other out. So in fact, we just have a 1 right here, and we have to differentiate that, right? So this is so wonderful, because this right here is just going to be plus 1 in the integral. So this right here is negative x lnx over 1 plus lnx, and then we just need to add the x. We are done. But I can make it slightly prettier for you guys, because this right here actually simplifies really well. Let's multiply the top and bottom by 1 plus lnx. And then you see this right here is just x plus x lnx. When we combine, this and that cancel. So ladies and gentlemen, this right here actually gives us x on the top over that, x over 1 plus lnx plus c. We are done. So yeah, this is what I like to show my students. They just have to really think hard on which part that they should be choosing from the integral to be integrated. Sometimes we just have to make things happen, and perhaps one of the best ways is you can start by asking yourself, wouldn't it be nice? And that's exactly what we did. And that's exactly what happened. And in fact, I got this integral. It's from the 100 derivative questions. I have a question just now. How can I integrate this and get back to that? That's a pretty nice question. Maybe do some use substitution. This is a hard one. And this is what I come up with for you guys. So let me know what you guys think about the LIATE right here. Would you use it? Would you not? Why or why not? I would say it's pretty good about like 80% of the time, but once we get to like trickier integrals, then we really just have to think really carefully, right? That's it.